guys, how you doing? My name is Joe, and welcome to episode number one of our Wurm Unlimited Let's Play series. This is actually episode two, kinda. I'm gonna fill you in on that fun ordeal in a minute. But anyway, Wurm Unlimited, if you guys are new to this, this is an amazing open world sandbox. And it started out as an MMO with Wurm Online, but they released a single player version, Wurm Unlimited, on Steam, but you can also join custom servers, and that's what we did today. We are joining the Requiem of Wurm server, so thank you very much for letting me come in here and film my Let's Play. It's awesome. It's got some sped up skill timers and that kind of thing to make things a little bit more enjoyable. But Wurm is pretty awesome. You just basically start off in the wilderness, you find a place to settle down, you can transform the world in any way you want with terraforming and farming, and you can just build a life. It's really good. It's a really great survival game. You have to grow your own food and fish and all kinds of good stuff. I'm a little bit flustered right now because I actually did already film episode one, but by the time I was all finishing up and I was doing my outro and I was all done and I smacked the record button, which would be the button to stop the recording, and I realized that I just started recording, which means that I wasn't recording anything for the last hour. I just have an hour worth of audio and no video, so that sucks. But you didn't really miss much because everything we did in the first episode, I pretty much covered in the Getting Started Basics video for Wurm Unlimited. So we basically just made a character, which was a basic character creation screen. You have a few different options for your head and your hair and that kind of stuff, but that's about it. We wandered around, found a nice place to settle down. We flattened out some land, foraged for some seeds, and planted a few seeds, and that's about it. So if you guys are new to Wurm and you don't know that, you can watch the basics video, but I'll be doing everything we already did in the first episode a million times more, so don't really have to worry about that. That's Wurm is full of foraging and flattening and all that good stuff. So anyway, what we did is we started in the Requiem of Wurm. I walked east, And there's a nice little village over there that's the dark side of the moon. Everything is named after Pink Floyd CDs and songs, which is cool. And I found a nice place to live. So now we're going to turn around. And this is basically what we have right now. We started with a tent. We started with all these tools. This kindling and acorns and cotton and stuff are things that I foraged on the ground by just right-clicking nature forage. And then right-clicking nature botanized. But these places are probably pretty picked clean because I was already here. I also leveled off a few squares here, flattened them out right over here. Started a little bit of a farm. I think I have two potatoes and two corn. So that's pretty good. They're a couple days along right now because I recorded this on Wednesday and today is Friday. So this episode, what I'm going to do is continuing our farm a little bit to try to do that. Might cook a little bit of a casserole. Our food is getting down a little bit. But other than that, we're probably going to have to start worrying about iron. We need to get some rock and some iron so we can build ourselves a house and just shelter ourselves from the wilderness. I picked this spot because it's pretty cool. We got a beach. It's a nice little inlet. And this game really does look pretty. I do like it a lot. One thing we have to keep an eye on, though, is there's a lot of bad guys over there. You can see there's some hellhounds over there in the distance. Quite a few. Some wolves. So there are some bad things we want to keep an eye out for, but I like it. It's a cool spot. So yeah, I'm kind of flustered, to be honest with you. I'm a little. I think I'm good now. I think I explained everything I did. So basically, Wurm is just a big sandbox. You do whatever the heck you want. It's all about community. So it's nice to find a spot with some neighbors where you can interact with each other. Maybe we'll do a little bit exploring in another episode and discover what people can build, because people can really build some cool things. And everyone started with a place like this, a big hilly place, and they leveled it off and built bridges and houses and structures, and it's just really cool. So I managed to find a few ingredients. We got a pumpkin here. We're probably going to save that for our first meal because it takes up a lot of weight. You can see a pumpkin weighs 1 pound or 1 kilogram, whatever they're going with. So that's pretty good. But now we got, I also picked this place because it's got quite a bit of exposed rock to it. So that's something good to keep in mind, although it is pretty high up here. I think this will do, though. What are we going to do? We're going to equip our pickaxe here, and we're going to mine and prospect this. see if we can find some iron nearby, because we really need iron. Iron is a very, very useful thing. It's pretty much like your coal in Minecraft. You know, without coal, you're lonely. You don't have any light. You're cold and you're dark. It's very similar. So we're gonna wander away down here. So I prospect that and said there's only rock nearby. So I don't want to tunnel into there. I want to find somewhere where we can find some iron. So I'm just gonna be careful now. We got this bull guy down here. He's not too bad. He's not gonna attack us. He's outlined in blue, so that's okay. But those guys down there, gotta be careful with those guys. Let's go mine and prospect again. Take a drink. It's Friday. I'm allowed to drink now. It's Friday. It's good. Only rock nearby. That's not good, though. Look at all those bad guys down there. We got, I don't know if that's a horse or not, though. That would be cool if it was a horse. I don't want to venture too old troll. Yeah, that's a bad guy, too. He will one hit us. Maybe two hit. I'm not sure, but either way, it's not good. Let's jump into freedom here and say hi to this guy. Hey, man. We want to be friendly. All these people are good. Wurm is... iron ore nearby. Awesome. Okay, so there's iron ore nearby here, so that's cool. So we have our pickaxe now. So we are going to mine, and we are going to start to tunnel our way in here. It's going to take quite a few actions. It's sped up now. So Wurm is all about... It's a waiting game. It really is. It's about waiting longer than the timers, I guess. And Wurm Unlimited, it's pretty good, because we have 5 times skill timers, I believe, in this server. So it's 5 times faster, maybe 3.5, I can't quite remember. But it's 5 times faster than the normal Wurm Online. So that's good. Wurm Online is slow, but it's so rewarding as well. So this is good too. So we are mining right now, and we are chipping away at the rock. So we're tunneling. So I don't believe you mine some rock shards. I don't think we actually get rock shards for this. Oh no, we do. Cool. So those rock shards are going to be useful. We can turn those things into gravel paths, cobblestone paths, something to liven up our place a little bit. But we can also turn those into brick, and we can make a house with them as well. So they're good. They're really heavy, though, so you don't want to be carrying them around. You can just leave them in the pile on the ground until you build some sort of wagon or something. We're also gaining our skills. We got pickaxe and mining increase, which is awesome. What else is going on right now? I think it takes 20 actions to actually chip it away. Can we examine this? Nope. I think it's 20 actions until you actually break through on the tunnel. I wish the tiles were even right now, but the way they're not, it's going to be a weird little entrance, but that's okay. It'll line up nice with our house. I want to build a house down there. So we're kind of looking on out on the outlet, and maybe a farm up in here as well. So we'll figure it out. So season one, and what I also wanted to do is, I am all over the place. I had this so nice in episode one. It was laid out so perfect. Didn't work out. That's okay though. But what I want to do is kind of have seasons for Wurm. So in this season, I want to have some goals. So we'll know when we're finished, because with Wurm, you can go on forever. You are never done. You know, you want a bigger house. You want to make a farm, you want to gain your skills, you want to become a priest, you know, you want to go to all the community events, you want to host a community event. It really is, the sky is truly the limit with that. Another thing I'm scared about is this angle. It's like gradual, so I don't know if it's going to be a cave-in problem as well. But it'd be cool to build something up there someday. But anyway, okay, I'm getting totally sidetracked. So for season one, what I want to do is I want to build a house, for one. So that's a big thing. I want to have a sizable field, nothing too crazy. Because remember, you have to tend every tile of crop. You know, the weeds and stuff. There's no automation for that, so nothing too crazy. I also want to have a little bit of livestock, maybe get that bull, maybe breed that bull a little bit. And so I think that's good. I want to have a farm, I want to have a house, I want to have a mine with iron, and I want to have a little bit of livestock. And I think that's going to be a good spot for season one. So that's our goals. So every episode we're going to work towards that. So right now we're trying to get our mine with iron. Without iron, we can't make nails, which means we can't make a house or a roof. Basically, iron is the first step. And to find iron, what you have to do is go to exposed rock, like I did, prospect it, look for iron. But if you don't have any exposed rock, go to the biggest hill you can find, something that's big, you know, not around sea level, and just start digging the dirt down. You may have to dig that really far down until you actually hit rock and then can mine into the rock. Why is this taking so long? I am tunneling this, right? Am I supposed to be tunneling this or am I supposed to be mining this? No, your surroundings need to be rock for you. Okay, no, we're supposed to be tunneling. It should say it's gonna break away soon. How many? Let's see, open 13. Okay, maybe it's 20. Maybe it's 20 here. We can also queue some up here. So, prospect tunnel. So let's queue up a few of those. Or apply to Jerabu. Jabaru. Or we'll apply to him. Let's queue up a few more of these. Not much. Let's see. Not much. Just recording a video. Smile. Oh, crap. Hit the wrong. Oh, that's not the right map. That's Wurm Unlimited's map. Oh, there we go. Okay, so we broke through. We have made our way into the mine. So that's cool. How many actions did that take? So that took 16 rock shards. It might be random. I'm not sure. So that's cool. So now that we're inside the cave, with Wurm, it's kind of like, I don't know, it's not true 3D. Like, so right now we're in a different world as when we go outside. I don't know how to explain it, but that's just how it is. Oh my god, we got lucky, guys. Huh. Look how lucky this is. I don't know if this is the way the server is set up, but the first time we tunneled in, there's an iron vein there. I don't know how. I couldn't even have planned that any better. That is beautiful. Usually that I am spending at least hours trying to find iron. So this is truly, truly amazing. I am pumped for that. So we are going to mine a little bit of iron here. Let's mine a bit. And then we'll take that back, start a fire, and we're going to smelt this down into iron ingots? It wouldn't be ingots. Iron lump, I think is what they call it. Because right now it's iron ore, and it is heavier than hell. So it takes up a lot of your stamina. And it's pretty hard to move. So let's take this now. We're not walking too slow. Again, we want to be very diligent. Don't get too close to that wolf because he will kill us. That troll is just wandering up that mountain like a boss. He must go to Zumba or something because he's got calves on him, man. He can climb that mountain. Hello, bull man. Adolescent bull. I wonder what my neighbors are doing. Let's say hi to Pinkish Floyd. And let's do the whole, oi! What is that again? Is it this one? Oh, crap, I'm not typing. Yeah, that's the hello. Okay. So now that we do have that, we want to take this log. Let's take that. Where did our inventory go? I must have closed that by mistake. Okay, let's take this. Want to take our steel and flint and click on our kindling. If you guys, I'm gonna go over this anyway. But again, you can watch the basics video to get all this. But in order to make kindling, you have to get this log. And the log I got by just equipping my axe and cutting down a tree. So you right click on the log and you go create. And you go kindling, and I have a 67% chance of creating kindling. You can also do it this way. You can click the crafting window. You can take your log, you can drag it in there, and you can also take your carving knife and drag it in there as well. So that's going to give me everything I can make with a carving knife and a log. So we can click on kindling, and we're going to create one of those. I can make up to three, and that goes with your strength, I think. The more strength you have, the more things you can queue up. So I made... you create a kindling, so I was successful in creating that. So now I want to equip my steel wool, and I want to right-click on a kindling, create furnace, and create a campfire.
The kindling contains too little. So that's, I must have already tried to do that and I failed. So you can see it has 1.35 weight. You need 1.5 to actually create a fire. But if I fail, it'll take 0.15 away and I won't be able to actually make a campfire with that kindling. But what I can do is I can highlight this, activate it, shift, and combine. So now it'll combine them all. So now I got one big old piece of kindling. And I can continue to try to make a campfire and fail. That's another part. But the higher you skill up, the better chance you have at creating stuff. So now if I examine this, it says it burns steadily and will burn for a long time. So it's going to burn for a while, but I want to fuel it with some fire because I don't have to worry about it for a while. We're going to open up the campfire here and we're going to drag our iron ore into here. Yes, it's telling me people can actually steal this stuff, but I think there's only two people on the server. I don't think they're going to jack my stuff yet. So that's okay. So we got our iron in the campfire and it's smelting. That is awesome. I am super excited. I can't believe we found iron so quick. Man, this is good. So I got crops growing here. Let's examine them. The crop grows steadily. I did rake those before the episode, so that's why that is like that. So what I'm going to do now, what should I do? I want to kind of, maybe I want to plant a house now. I think a house right over here would be cool. We do have to be careful with these guys, though. But let's, I think I would like a house, like, kind of overlooking this stuff right here. I think this view is beautiful. So let's make one, two, I want to make a, where are we at here? I want to make a 2x3 house. That's my goal. So a 2x3 house right here. Maybe we'll start there. 2, 3, do. Cool. Okay, so let's equip our shovel right now. And let's just pack this down. Another pro tip. Before you actually disturb any land, you always want to forage and botanize on it to see if there's any stuff on there, because once you pack it, it goes away. So if you missed out on the seeds that were in that grass, you would miss it. So let's forage and botanize again. Oh, we're going to get something. Foraging, I think you get more seeds, and botanizing, you get more stuff for like herbs and like medicine. You can make healing covers and stuff like that with all this good junk. So let's forage and botanize this again. Now we do have a sword. We are graced with a sword, but we're not skilled enough to actually take on that black wolf. But that's why it's kind of good to mosey on up to a neighbor, because if I got really in trouble, what I could do is, maybe that's what we'll do today as well. We do have a deed stake. We should probably do that before we get too intense. We do have a deed stake now. So what a deed stake is in Wurm, you get a deed. And a deed is a X amount of plot of land. And on that land, you are granted a spirit Templar. And that Templar will help you fight off bad guys. Help you save you. But the main thing is, once you have the deed, anything in that deed can't be stolen. It can't be bashed. Any structures you have on the deed will decay slow. Anything outside a deed will decay really quickly. It saves people from, you know, building something and then just walking away and it's sitting there forever. Maybe we'll do that. So we have that here. That wolf is getting close. We're gonna have to put that. I am kind of scared of that. Let's pack this thing here. Now, everyone works different. The deeds cost money. So, I don't know how much money we actually get with this. Let's ask in the chat. How big of a deed do we get to start? Do you know? So it all depends. Let's see. Let's go settlement. Found a settlement. We're going to found a settlement. So this form is what we need to fill out to actually found a settlement. This deed is an epic. Okay, that's not. So some of this stuff is related to Wurm Online. It actually has no relevance to the Wurm Unlimited. This epic and challenge clusters, those are servers in the Wurm. Anything within reason. So anything within reason. Awesome. Okay, so we are going to start the settlement application. So what we want to do now, I think we'll go with a 15 by 15. That's quite big. 15 wet. Maybe we'll go 15 by. Let's see, where are we at now? North and south are where we wanna do it, because that's the mountainous area there. So west is kind of wasted with the water there. So we'll check. Let's go 15 and 15. And we're just gonna show, survey the area, sorry. Okay, so once we survey the area, so this actually, so 15 actually does pretty well. It takes us right to the deed border. It takes us right over to there, and it takes us up to there. So that's a pretty nice little deed size. We might go a little bit more just to encompass our mine there. We don't want to lose that. Not that anybody's really going to encroach us. I don't think there's too many people on this actual server. So let's go back a bit here. We might go, what was this, east and west? North and south, okay. North, let's go 25 to the north. And we will go 25 to the south as well. So let's survey the area again. So that brings us way up there. And okay. Is that the tile border or deed border? Okay, so that brings us, that does pretty good at encompassing our mine, actually. Quite a ways up on that. And we, I don't know, do we want a little bit more there? No, I think we'll leave that. I don't want to be too greedy. That's a nice little green space in between us and those other guys. And we do have all this space over here as well. So maybe I'm getting greedy. It's free. He said whatever we want within reason. I mean, come on. What's reason? I have no idea. Let's go. So maybe we'll go a little bit into the water here. Just you know, just a tiny bit west. Let's go 20. All right, I think that's fair. Okay, so we're gonna go continue on. So we'll survey the area. That's good. Perimeter size is 5 tiles. Plus 5 tiles is fine. So the perimeter, it's more like, it's more in Wurm Online. All this stuff costs money. It costs upkeep. So the more tiles you have, the more money it costs, and the more upkeep it costs every month. You have to put copper or silver coins into your settlement token to contribute to upkeep. So the bigger deed you have, the more money it costs, the more upkeep it costs. It's a good way to constrain people from making huge deeds. You can get money from trading with people, crafting items and selling them to people. I you can buy it with real money as well. So it just depends. The tile border, it keeps people from deeding right up next to your deed. That way you don't have people just butt up against each other. 5 tiles for me is fine. Again, when you're in a private server, it doesn't really matter. We're just doing this because it'll give us a little bit more protection from the bad guys, as well as protect our stuff from getting stolen, and most importantly, our stuff won't decay as fast. So that's good. That's fine. We'll click survey area again. What do we want to call this name? We're going to call this Springton, because that's what we call everything. Springton. The settlement motto is... settlement motto. What do we want our settlement motto to be? We will make it, hey guys, because that's what I always say. Make this a democracy. No, I am the mayor. I will do what I want. Cool. Save this name. Awesome. Springton. So we are a size of 41 by 51. We have selected 5 tiles. Area proceeds. Please note, do you wish to hire guards? Springton can hire up to 20 guards. The only guard types are heavy guard. There is no cost for hiring guards here. How many guards would you like to hire? Let's hire 3 guards. I don't think we need more than 3 guards, so let's save that number of guards. So we have 3 guards. The maximum citizens can we have, including guards, is 190. So if you guys want to come join my my town, my Springton, you can, up to 190 of you. So I think we'll be okay. If not, we'll just expand. The motto is, hey guys. The settle is, okay, good. Okay, found the settlement. Awesome. Man, congratulations. You are now proud citizen of, okay. Wait, did I want to be mayor? Oh, you become the mayor and first citizen of Springton. Okay. The deed for the settlement has been placed in your inventory. Awesome. You can change the size of your deed and perimeter if you wish. Remember to keep the money and upkeep otherwise. Okay. Lords of Wurm. Thank you, Lords of Wurm. Finish. Cool. So now we have this. We will have a few guards. So the guards are going to kill these bad guys for us. So we don't have to worry about them. The guards can take on whatever the heck we want. Man, I am pumped. We have, thank you. I'll just let them know. If it's too big, let me know. But I think 20 by 20 is okay. And holy crap, my frames are taking a dump. I have no idea what's going on right now. I'm going to take a drink, though. And usually when I move, it must be hitting a glitch or something. Let's see. Let's hit maybe... no, that doesn't save it. That doesn't change anything. Oh, my God. All right, I don't know. It must have hit a bug or something. I had that problem with Software Inc. too. It must be a memory thing. But anyway, okay. So now we have a good spot. This is our settlement token. So now we have this. We can deposit our money, deposit our good things, and they're safe. Another good thing about settlement tokens that I almost forgot is when you die, you will now spawn here instead of spawning back at the start village. So this is really good if you wandered way out into the wilderness to find that perfect virgin piece of land. Man, I slayed that piece of land. And, you know, you don't want to walk all the way back. So let's go to settlement. So I think you can also make it automatically send updates to Twitter, which is pretty goddamn cool. So let's go to info, sprints in, mottos, hey guys. And the upkeep is, let's see, show role for mayor of Springton. Oh, that's cool. So we can brand animals, we can breed. That's really cool. That's really cool. And we did. We hired 3. And more meat. Cool. Okay. That's awesome. All right. So we got that. So now we want to build our house right here on our beautiful new settlement. So we'll do this. We'll keep the upkeep thing there. It's fun. Let's equip our hatchet. We're going to cut down this tree. And equip your shovel again. We want to pack this. So now bear with me. It's been a while since I played Wurm, so don't totally judge me. But now what we're gonna want to do is we're gonna want to make a few tools. I think we need a small anvil in order to make some nails, because nails are pretty important. But we also need a hammer. Do we have a hammer? I believe we don't have a hammer, so that's going to be something we're going to need pretty soon. So what we can do here, I know we're going to need a shaft or a hammer. I don't think I have one. I thought I could have sworn we started with a hammer, but I guess not. So what we're going to want to do here is go grab a log. And open this. If you want religion, that's something I don't know about. I've never really dabbled into that. So let's create tool parts. I think I want a shaft for this. I think that's what we need. We created a shaft. Awesome. So let's open up our crafting menu here. Put this in there as well. Now I think if we put a log in here. No, we can't make anything. Oh, I think I know what I need. So let's get rid of that. Let's put our, I think I need to make a mallet head. And then once I have my mallet head, then I can make a, okay. Are my frames taking a dump again? Oh, this is frustrating. All right, hopefully that's, I fixed some of that. I'm not sure. It's a problem with Fraps somewhere. It's dumping all my memory. I'm not sure. But anyway, we're going to figure this out. Okay, so we're trying to make a mallet head. Maybe if I just... Nope. Okay, so if I equip the shaft and I go to there. Okay, if I equip that and go. So I got the carving knife, I right click on shaft. I can't make anything. I know tool parts. I know it's in here somewhere. I'm just, something's fighting something. My guard is killing. Oh, look at my guard over there. He's fighting. What is he fighting? Old wildcat bleeding, so we can butcher that up. We have some meat, which is really good because food is good. Okay, so we have this now. Why can't I figure this out? So we have a carving knife. I'm trying to create. A mallet head. So what if I do? What can I make with rock shards? What if I do rock shards? I have no idea. I've never used actual rock shards before crafting. Can I look things up with this? Oh, okay, I can. Cool. Okay, you can see that. Let's go mallet. Oh, this is much easier. Mallet. Mallet head carpentry. Awesome. We need one of these. So what do we have to do? Starting items, a crude knife, and a shaft. I have carving knife and a shaft. I have all of those. So it's telling me I need a carving knife and a shaft. So I have that. And now let's take the carving knife and put it in there. I have all of that. Now why can't I make a mallet head? And why is my computer doing this to me now? Again. Let's try turning the other way. We'll just ignore the frames. No, it's okay. We're just gonna look at this red tent. Solid texture. Look at that. I don't even have to render anything. We're inside a tent. Don't need to render stuff. Awesome. No need to render. My frames can come back now. It's okay. No. Damn it. Oh my god, I am a dumbass. This is a staff. This isn't even a shaft. Do you know what? The amount of times I have done that before in the... Oh my god, I'm dumb. Don't make a staff, guys. Make a shaft. Say no to staffs. Alright, create mallet head. My god, I am stupid. Okay, so now we have a mallet head. Oh my god, I can't believe I did that. Oh, shoot. Okay. This frame thing is really driving me nuts, though. You almost made it. Oh, thank god, I almost made it. Okay, mallet head, please. You almost made it. Damn, son of... These are 5 times faster, though, which is good. Can you imagine 25 seconds to figure out you failed that? So we're going to do that. Create tools, mallet. It's not enough. Okay, so we need to make... Let's grab our carving knife. And go to this. Create tool parts. Shaft. Okay, so now almost made it again. Create tool parts, shaft. You create a shaft, cool. Okay, so let's go to that, and where is our shaft? Awesome. And let's right click on this. Oh, did I try to... I created a staff again? God, why do I keep doing that? They should really just get rid of that option. I don't need to make any of those ever. Staff, tool parts, construction material, shaft. Man, that feeling when you make a staff instead of a shaft. You get shafted, bro. You get shafted. We're gonna have to probably cook something soon, too. Create a shaft. Cool. So let's take our... Where is it? Where's our shaft? Let's take our shaft that is big and create tools mallet. You can do it. You can do it. Acknowledge. You create a mallet. That's pretty cool. So now what we can do, where is our fire at? Right below us. Spin it around. Open up. So we have iron lump. Good. We have 3 pounds of it. Probably going to need more iron. The quality is horrible, but... That's okay. We're just starting out. It doesn't really matter. Let's combine those. And now, let's see what we can create. Create small anvil. Cool. We can do that. We have enough. So hopefully we can make a small anvil. Almost made it, but it's useless. I don't know how much it actually takes to create a small anvil. But a small anvil is what we need to start. With that, we can make a... Sweet, we made a small anvil. So now let's drop that on the ground just because it looks pretty. You're dropping an item. Usually if you stay within one tile of the item, nobody else may pick it up unless you team up with them. Otherwise, well, we shouldn't. We are inside. Examine. This is within the village of Springton. Okay. We shouldn't lose it because we're in the city. Yeah. Anyway, I don't think anybody's going to steal our mallet. But that looks pretty cool. Just look at that. That looks epic. It looks beautiful. Cool. So now that we have that, what we want to do is we're going to need to make... See, what I don't know is, do I want to make a brick house or do I want to make a wooden house? See, a brick house, I'm going to need a few things for a brick house. So that's going to be a problem. But we are going to have some meat around here, right? Because our guards are going to be fighting. I'm going to only do one more thing and then we're actually going to go. What I'm going to do is cook a meal. So now what I could do to cook a meal is I could open this. I could take my pumpkin, and probably that's about it because I don't have anything else. But I could throw my pumpkin in with a potato and cook a meal, and that would be okay. You'll make a casserole because I'm making it inside my pottery bowl, and that's good. The more things you add, the harder it gets. But you're trying to get that weight up because the bigger, the more substance it is, the more it heals. But we have a lot of meat around here because we have a settlement, we have guards, and those guards are attacking animals. So we want to be able to butcher those corpses so we can get that meat. In order to do that, we need a carving knife. No, a butcher knife. That's what we want. A butcher knife. So let's go here. And we will type butcher knife, bladesmithing. So what we want is a small iron and an iron lump, but I don't know how much iron lump we actually need. Anyway, let's try. So let's take our iron lump. Let's see. It's still glowing from the heat. So in order to smith with anything, you need to have it glowing with heat. Your anvil doesn't have to be, but... So we want a butcher knife blade. We only have 39% to create that. Contains too little material, so we need some more iron ore. So let's take a walk up here, because there should be a corpse up here. I think our guard actually killed something. I think it was over here. I don't know where his corpse is. It's kind of hard to see in the long grass, but I heard him fighting. Is that it? No. Around here somewhere. What we can do is we can go pick a fight with something though and just bring it over. I am so, like, you guys don't understand how excited I am. That iron is so close to my camp. It is awesome. We'll mine a bit of this. Actually, let's stop this. We'll wait for our stamina to refill. See, now our food is down and our water is also down, so our stamina refills slower than if it was 100%. Mine some iron ore. I don't know how much we need. We'll mine a few. And while that's doing that, well, maybe we'll level out a little bit for our house. And then once that's smelted, we can combine the two into a beautiful, beautiful, nice iron lump. And that should be good. Okay, let's take that. And we'll walk back. I don't know where that corpse is, though. I could have sworn it was up around here somewhere. I can't believe I made a staff. Oh my god, how stupid am I? Staff? Who the heck makes a staff? I could have sworn it was around here. That's kind of why I'm making this thing, is so I can butcher that animal, but I don't know where the heck it is. This is the guy that killed it. Hello, guy that killed it thing. Thank you. Maybe it disappeared. Or somebody else got it. Oh, we got a horse over there? Are those horse or hellhounds? I'm not sure. Let's see. Yeah, those are hell horses. Those aren't good guys. That's for sure. corpse of an aged black wolf. Cool. So there is a corpse over there. We can go butcher that one. But what's this? You're low on stamina. Oh, yes, I know that. Let's examine this. Oh, crap. It's going to burn out. So let's take our... No, you know what we're going to do? We're going to take our staffs and we're gonna burn those because those are friggin' bad memories. And we will also take all our wood scraps because those are... They're useful for things. However, they aren't useful for us right now. So let's combine those. They're good for making kindling and stuff. And you can also make some fences out of them and all that good stuff. But let's open this up. Put our iron ore in there. Well, actually, we'll put this other lump in there too because we need to keep that glowing from the heat. And we'll walk down to the water. Get a drink. So we can fill our water up, our thirst. I think this is going to be a great spot, guys. Look at this. Beautiful here. Isn't it? And then look at that boat over there. You can build that. That would take forever to build, though. Takes a long time. But we got lots of time. Corpse of mature hellhound. So there are things dying over here, which is good to see. Good, good. Okay. So while that's going there, let's go equip our shovel. And let's take a walk over here and we'll start leveling out this piece of land. Just while that stuff is smelting, and then we'll level this out and then I think we'll jump off. But okay, so where do we want to start? Let's start up on this hill. We'll level it off with this. So let's go here. So we have this equipped, right? It's four slopes down. So we're going to dig this down four slopes. One, two, too far away. Let's dig. Why does it still say it's four slopes? Should not be four slopes down. Okay. Let's try this now. Dig. Oh, there we go. Can we dig now? Why is it saying too far away? Not far away. I'm standing right on top of it. Nah, three slopes, two slopes, dig. One slope. So this sign is flat. That's two slopes. And that's one slope. So we will take some dirt. That's two slopes up. So we're going to drop two dirt here. Drop on ground. Good enough. It's flat, so that's two slopes down. So we need actual two, and this should be two slopes up. Two slopes up. So we need to put two dirt down in this corner. Drop on ground. So that's flat. That's flat. And so this should be flat. This should be a flat tile right here. So now let's take our shovel. Man, our frames are horrible. Garbage. I gotta switch. Anybody has any suggestions on things I can record with besides fraps, that would be good. So I can flatten all that out the same way as I just did that one. And that'll be our place for our house. I'll probably do that off camera because fraps is being a tool and I don't like it. But yeah. Oh, that was a bear. I don't know why I thought that was a bear. That was a rock. That's okay. Let's go here. Hopefully our iron lump is, no, it's still iron ore. It's searing hot right now. Do you know what? Maybe we'll save that for the next episode. I think I gotta get off because my frames are crap. So, yeah. Anyway, guys, if you like this episode and you want to see more, leave a comment in the comment section. Be like, yo, Joe, this was great. I want to see more of this stuff. And you can also smack that subscribe button if you haven't already. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.